Do you think those nurses will ever get away from that man?
Perhaps they could go faster if they took off the tight-fitting uniforms.
Oh, look, you were right.
Do you get the feeling that Benny has a healthy and fulfilling sex life?
You're taking it too seriously, Dylan. It's a comedy programme. It's supposed to make you laugh.
Well, it's meant to be funny as well.
Don't mind me. I'm just putting some clothes in the machine. Eric, I thought you could wear this on your birthday. It makes you look so handsome.
Mum, why would I want to dress up on my birthday?
I didn't know it was your birthday.
Well, you never know what's going to happen on your birthday.
Hey, everyone, Eric's having a birthday.
Mum, I don't want a party.
Oh, well, hark at Mr. Sniffy. He doesn't want to have a party. As if I've got time to plan one. Oh, and by the way, Helen's coming home from university this weekend. No reason. She just is.
Well, Eric, it looks like you're having a party. And the exciting thing is, it's going to be a complete surprise.
Eric, I've just realised, Donna is older than you.
Only by a month.
Good for you, Eric.
Good for me what?
In my country, it's good luck to fall in love with an older woman.
Tor?
No, they come with livestock.
Morning, Eric.
Morning. Oh, I'll get it. Oh, let me.
Mum, did I just see about 25 bags of chipsticks in there?
They were reduced.
Mum, I don't want a party.
There is no party.
The lad doesn't want a party.
He's not having a party.
Well, don't arrange one.
I'm not.
He's too old for surprise parties.
I agree with you.
Then stop shouting.
I'm not.
Dad, I know money's short since you got your hours cut back, so, you know, I'm not expecting a big birthday or anything.
I'll be the judge of when money's short round here. So what do you want for your birthday? And don't worry about the price, as long as it's reasonable.
I want a cassette player, yeah. One I can use in the car, a cassette deck, not an 8-track.
8 tracks? All at the same time? Must sound awful. I don't know why they just don't put record players in cars.
No, I don't want an 8-track.
Then you won't get one.
I think he wants one.
No, no, I want a cassette player, not an 8-track machine.
Then, that's what you shall have.
Not an 8-track.
You'll get a quality piece of equipment. In fact, it'll probably last longer than the car.
It doesn't have to be expensive.
There's your first mistake, son. You should always buy the best you can afford.
But, Dad, you said I should always buy British.
Don't be cheeky.
Sorry, Dad. I'm off out now.
Good. Now, go to the corner shop for me and buy a bag of icing sugar, 10 packets of Smarties and 4 large Swiss rolls. Are for your sister. Phew, that was close. I am giving Eric a surprise party.
Yes, I know.
But soon, he'll be a man, and he won't want a party then.
He doesn't want a party now.
This could be my last chance to see my baby blow out his candles.
Stop it, Kitty, you're breaking my heart.
Tor?
Yes?
What are you doing?
I'm praying at the tomb of the tiny people.
Oh, this is hopeless. What am I going to get Eric for his birthday?
Well, you know what he really needs? Cold, hard cash for threads and sounds.
Dylan, you can't give money as a present.
Hey, you can try on me anytime.
All breakages must be paid for.
Break it? Mate, it's plastic.
Look, don't get funny with me, sunshine. Buy the turd or get out.
Michael, what are you doing?
You know, thinking. Better present.
I've got 10p. Let's do the passion tester. Now, grab this. Michael, stop looking at your friends and look at me.
Okay, then.
Cold fish, Michael. Cold fish. Are you sure you're thinking about me?
How am I doing then? Am I hot stuff yet? I am, aren't I?
Oh, God, look at that. 3 weeks, and already they need electric devices to spice up their love life.
Go on.
What?
What have you got, Eric, for his birthday?
Oh, I didn't get him anything. Nothing looked right. I just want to get him something really special.
He kissed you, didn't he?
Jackie?
Oh, come on, let's go into the car so we can talk about it. I bet I can give you some great advice. Okay,
so what's going on? Jackie, I really don't want to talk to you about this.
Well, who else are you going to talk to about it?
Payback! Okay. After we got back from the Cockney Rebel concert, we were sitting on the bonnet of the car, and I kissed him.
French or English?
I can't believe I'm talking to you about this. Okay, look. I've lived next door to Eric my whole life, and he's my best friend, and we love the same music, and we talk about everything, and then I kissed him, and now everything's changed, and I'm thinking he might be my boyfriend, but if he's my boyfriend, then I'm going to lose my best friend, right? And then if I muck it up, I lose my boyfriend and my best friend. And now I've got to get him his birthday present, and I don't know. All I could see was fart powder.
You can stop talking now. I've solved it. Get him a scented candle.
A scented candle.
Romantic and practical. Oh, yeah.
I have won control of the plastic plate. None of you shall be enjoying your supper tonight.
Tor, you didn't win. You just wouldn't let go.
Yes, but I have control of the plate. And... Holy Mother.
Hi, Helen.
Hello, Maguire. Dylan.
Who is this goddess?
Oh, the goddess is Eric's sister.
She's no goddess. She's more of a chew-you-up, spit-you-out, earth-mother whore type. Which is my favourite.
Helen. Eric.
Put some more clothes on.
Why?
Well, aren't you cold?
No. In fact, I'm hot.
Well, then why don't you go back into the house?
Because I'm waiting for my stuff to finish spinning. And I want you to stop hassling me. It'll only take me a minute.
I don't think Maguire will last that long.
Too bad. It's not like I'm completely naked under this. I am wearing underwear. See? If I was at a swimming pool, you wouldn't even notice me.
If we were at the swimming pool, Maguire would be in the water right now.
So, little brother, I hear you have a zephyr now. I want it tomorrow night. I need it.
Okay, but I need a favour.
For you? I'm afraid not.
Oh, come on. All you have to do is tell Mum I'm too old for a surprise party.
But you're the baby. And Mummy loves a baby.
If you do it, you can have the zephyr.
All night?
All night.
Okay, it's a deal.
Baby.
Oh, your sister fancies me. You saw her chatting me up, yeah?
Just let him go.
Remember, because I said, hi, Helen, and Helen said...
Hello, Maguire.
I'm waiting, and I want you all night. Baby.
Take me.
I want it.
Bad.
I need it.
Mummy loves her baby.
I'm completely naked under this.
And I'm hot.
For you,
Maguire.
What? Didn't you hear it?
So how's your friend Janet?
Pregnant.
She was such a nice young lady. How did that happen?
Well, first the egg comes down the fallopian tube to the uterus, while at the same time...
For God's sake, Eric, there are women present.
Hey, Dad, I think Mum and I know what a fallopian tube is.
I just don't like my little boy bandying about those types of unnecessary words. You're still my baby.
Thanks, Mum. Helen?
Stop staring at your sister and eat your tea.
Oh, yeah. Eric wanted me to say he thinks he's too old for a birthday party. Keys?
There's no party! Careless talk costs lives.
Just remember, I can't lend you the Zephyr due to the fact that I hate you.
Helen, you can't drive that heap. It's old and it's falling apart. Could break down anywhere and leave you at the mercy of any maniac that comes along. It's all right for Eric. Take the toy out, Jack. Oh, and, here's a fiver.
Will that fill the tank?
Well, it should do. But, Ron, give her another one, just in case.
Dad, if you could give me some cash, perhaps I could take the guys down to the coast at the weekend.
Yeah, yeah, and if a frog had wings, it wouldn't bump its arse when it hopped.
I'm coming.
Donna? It's 3 a.m. Are you going mad?
Mad? Only mad in love with you. What is it about you that drives me so wild with passion and desire, Eric?
Well, I am vice treasurer of the student council, licensed to suspend your library for shitload days.
Shut up and go and sit down. I have to give you a birthday present. It can't wait any longer. Close your eyes.
This is my present.
No, that's my nightie. I'm your present. Now open your eyes, birthday boy.
And that's it. A few presents tonight, the end. So don't go thinking you're getting any party, because you'll just be bitterly disappointed.
Happy birthday, son. You know the lawn won't mow itself.
Happy birthday, baby brother. Nice tent.
I know why you're all here.
Don't know what you're talking about, man. You know, we're just hanging around as usual. Only I put on my best shirt tonight. So is everyone else, by chance. Doesn't mean anything.
Yoo-hoo! Sorry to disturb you kids. Dylan, Donna, Jackie, Maguire, young man with the accent. I wonder if you could give me a hand with something. Not you, Eric!
God, I can't stand it. I just can't do it.
No, Dad, back in. Get in there and enjoy your party.
Yes, Dad.
Hey, Rick, can you come in here for a minute?
Open it.
Oh,
Wow. I mean, great.
It's an 8-track.
I see that.
Just like you wanted.
You made such a fuss about it that I wrote it down.
Thanks, Mum. Dad, it's really great. Cassettes? Great. Thanks, Dylan.
You're welcome.
Oh, maybe we could play them on the 8-track.
It's a Remington Microchet.
I liked it so much, I bought you one on the company.
You won't need that for a long time. A long, long time.
Oh, yes, he will. He's almost a man.
Here, Eric, I bought you something.
Donna, no! Help me find my handbag now.
Jackie, you didn't bring a handbag.
Listen, don't give him the present in front of the lads.
I am one of the lads.
Don, I've put a lot of thought into this present. Please don't spoil it for me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I suppose I was being selfish.
It's okay.
Do you know, Eric, I can still see you and our little Donna when you were 2 years old, splashing around in the paddling pool, naked.
You were so sweet. We took pictures.
Speaking of naked pictures, I am Torbjörn.
Hello.
And you are?
My wife. Trust me, she'd break you in half. And if she didn't, I would. Well, we'd better be going. Bye, kids. And don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Oh, time for us to make a move.
What? No, the party's only just started.
I know. That's why we're going over to Bob and Midge's.
No. I want to give a party for Eric.
And you have. You make any mess, there'll be hell to pay.
Well, what about if we run out of Arctic rolls?
Let's go!
No, there's more paps, and there's coleslaw if you don't like Thousand Islands!
Okay, I'd love to stay, but fortunately I've got a real party to go to. With my three best friends, sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
They're friends of ours too, and we haven't seen the Frasers. Do you mind if we tag along?
I don't think so, Earache.
Come on, we won't cause any trouble. We'll just hang out. You know, in a cool way.
What, and groove to the Bay City Rollers?
Hey, fella. You know, I'm not seeing you, Bopper. I'll come to the party with you.
Okay. I'll drive, and you can hitch a lift on a flying pig.
Now, you must have seen that.
Let the dream live.
Well, he's bound to know about revolvers, so he could have shot him. Right, Colonel Mustard with the revolver in the kitchen.
Bob is extremely good at Cluedo.
What about the homebrew?
The cellar's locked.
Well, what if there's an emergency?
What kind of emergency requires homebrew?
But what if there's an accident?
They'll ring.
But what if they run out of crisps?
They'll starve.
I'm going to make a gin and tonic. Ron?
Kitty wants one.
I'm just worried. Helen's leaving.
She's at college. She doesn't want to spend her time with them.
Well, I should just ring. Just
for God's sake, woman. What can happen to them?
What can happen? Plenty. Plenty can happen. Now that the grown-ups have gone, we can be as bad as we want to be. Who wants to give Eric a venereal disease?
Hey, what? Drinks coasters. I hate coasters.
Please, chaps, my mum put out coasters for a good reason. I think I'll put my drink directly on the table. That way it will leave a ring. No! Why, oh, why didn't I beg my mother to stay? Quiet, you foolish Englishman. I am trying to make a long-distance telephone call at your parents' expense. But that's immoral! Ha! In my country of wherever it is I'm from, I can never remember. Morals get in the way of a good, dirty time. But first, I need some crisps. What? No more crisps? I'm ready, and Grandma shoots something. No, not goosey goosey sweetie jar.
You're overreacting.
Kitty.
When Valerie went away to college, I felt just the same way. But this little book of poems helped me. It's called Verses from an Empty Nest.
Read her the one about the little bird that left home and lost its way.
Here it is. Outside the nest, the bird can't fly. It needs its mum, or it will die.
Well, I think I'd like another drink.
Sweetie, you usually only have one.
Yes, but tonight I'm having two.
Okay, so wait by the porch and I'll get Eric.
But it's dark out there.
And you're giving him a candle. Here, matches.
He might not want to light it.
Don't say that. Don't even think it. Now, when he opens it, he'll say something like, groovy. And then you should give him a look like this.
I don't think I can give anybody that look.
Of course not, that's my look. You have to work on your own look.
I got you something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's empty.
I know. But it won't be when we get enough money together to visit Big Nige.
Great.
So, what did you get from Donna?
Oh, nothing yet.
Maybe you'll get the big present. You know, the really big present. You know what I mean when I say the big present?
McGuire, we know what you mean.
We know what you mean, man.
I'm not from here, and even I know what you mean.
Eric, Donna's waiting by the porch.
He's getting the big present.
A patchouli candle. This is really groovy.
It's nothing.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You look like you might be ill or something.
No, I'm just being completely stupid.
It's usually my job.
I was just nervous, you know, about the present.
The present's great. I'd light it if I had some matches.
You thought of everything.
Well, happy birthday.
Just keep moving, nothing to see in here.
We have candles in the bedroom, don't we?
I think this is it. He might actually be about to do it.
Yeah, but it's his birthday, so why doesn't she kiss him first?
Because she did that last time.
What?
Oh, shut up and just watch.
Come on, Eric.
Come on, man.
The window's open and we can hear you.
Yep, and we can see you.
Is he kissing her?
Talk. None of us can see them.
Eric, are you kissing her?